Good evening, Dragon Ball Z and Dragon Ball Z Universe fans. This is Dragon Ball Z Universe Team League, where we take two teams of three and pit them in a best two out of three last man standing matchup. Sponsored by Electrostatic Media. Forget League of Legends. Forget Street Fighter. This is Dragon Ball Z Universe, the greatest fighting game of all time. I'm your host, Cake, and
let's get ready to rumble!
And live from Madison Square Garden, I'm your host, Cake. Just kidding. This is pre-recorded material. I did that so that the game would flow a lot easier when you're watching. I'm just going to commentate on what's going on in the video for those who don't understand. I am Cake What Is Love, and I am up against Vale, which is a female boo character. I do some key normals, go in, and she evades out of that. I'm using Change the Future just in case, but oh, and she goes in, and I go use God of Destruction's Wrath. That does a lot of damage, even if you're far away. It's amazing how much damage that does. And she looks like she might have Shine Shot, and I'd go in for an evasion into God of Destruction's Wrath. It's a good, and looks like I use Phantom Fist, but I forgot that that ultimate attack right there has a finisher. And I am looking like I'm going in for some pokes. Namek's do have the longest pokes in the game, and it looks like I'm going for a wild ball. See if this will hit. And she is so close to me, I'm going to be using Spirit Ball just to keep her a bit away. Anytime that Namek's health is underneath 70% health, their health regenerates. So it is an uphill battle if you do not go in fast enough. And here you go, Change the Future into hit. Good counter, but her ultimate still goes off, and I have to use up three stamina bars for an evasion, and I miss that hit and the Phantom Fist away, but can't use it completely to get away. The tournament rules are you cannot spam Phantom Fist, so I am trying my hardest in this match not to overuse it, because it is an overpowered skill. Right there, I'm wave dashing across the plane, and hoping to get some movement going around. But she is keeping her distance, but look like we have a life, even on the life there, but I'm losing on the life, and I got a Destruction Wrath, always gets them whenever they charge in, and there goes the Phantom Fist, but I take the full damage, there's the evasion, Mach Dash goes behind the opponent, looking for something to happen. Vale goes right into me, but she is able to knock me out of that trick. Here's Change the Future. Counter attack does a lot of damage, and she's about to use an ultimate for whatever reason. Oh, look at those reflexes in her face, and the game goes to me. I'm trying my best, but this is kind of brand new. For everybody who's brand new to this game, there's a lot of skills more than any other fighting game out there right now, other than the old Budokai games and everything. And I keep using that God of Destruction's Wrath as a punish for anybody who does go in. Looks like Vel's built more aggressively in the way that she uses that super that she used. And there goes an easy combo into her ultimate. But that does leave you in a small stun space, stun time that you can't do anything. And looks like she had a perfect guard off of that spirit ball. And if you get a perfect guard, sometimes it does glitch out on you, and you can get a free attacking like you just saw. Her ultimate doing some damage in, but my stamina regens so fast. And oh, there goes a little trick for you. For anybody who does God of Destruction's Wrath, you can use that. And there's the Phantom Fist. Perfect timing. And Vel is going in, just boost dashing. Vel does not do any jump vanishes, and you don't have to do it, but it does add some movement ability to you. And I don't understand how Vel got caught in there, but she had enough to use three stamina bars for an evasion. And there is the ill flash. And into a normal combo, goes behind, give me a kiss, pucker up, and the KO does a ton of damage. Maiden Blast, I love it. And the next fight was Crow versus Wizard of Evil. Crow, I love the way your character looks. It's like Secret Agent, man. Seriously, look at that. It's pretty hot. And give me some of that cologne, because He is smelling up the room pretty good. Tried to do a maximum charge, and Crow said, it ain't gonna happen to me today. And, oh, is this going to be a Manny Pacquiao versus Mayweather fight? No, because we're about to have a perfect one more hit. And Crow says, I'm taking the gold perfect home onto the next match between Crow versus Wizard of Evil. Looks like their Crow is not letting up at all. He keeps going in. But Wizard, known for his grabs and perfect blocks on my team, he keeps grabbing all the time. But Crow is, or Wizard is out of stamina. Both going for a arm crash. And Wizard gets it, but he does not capitalize on the punishment. Crow is knocking him down. Both now have about the same equal health. But Crow, with the mad... damage percentile, you can tell he's carrying 100 in melee attribute. He does so much damage on his normals. And Wizard going in with the ult, but Crow had enough stamina to get out of it. The best time to use that ult is whenever you get them in a guard crash or their stamina bar goes gray, because they you can easily dodge out of the ultimate. It counts as multiple hits. Crow with the mock dash boost is going in, and he is unstopping. He's relentless. Oh, and the finish goes to Crow. On to the third matchup between my team member. Let's check it out. My team member, I can't remember. Shade, Super Shade versus Cinder Stroke. Shade with the Frieza Paralysis. Is able to capitalize on it if he gets the hit off, but he's going for a Shoryuken. This is not Street Fighter. There's the perfect block, but a mock dash saves him from the punish, and there he goes, the victory rush, and he still gets the hits in, but not too much damage in. But Shade is not letting up on Stroke. He is not letting him out of the corner. He is going in. Will we see a major destruction here going on? But Stroke is going for that Godbreaker, but Shade is nowhere around to capitalize off that Godbreaker. Stroke tries to go make use of something, but Shade is recovering stamina enough to do more damage. Victory rush. Will it hit? Oh, and it hits the last one. The last hit of all ultimates always does the most damage. Stroke going in for the Super Saiyan Spirit Ball, and it does do quite a bit of damage. Looks like it's taking off Shade's about 10 to 15% health there, but Stroke is still in the red. Super Shade can't capitalize, and he does with the paralysis, but a grab. He says, don't use your evasion on me. I'm going to slap you in the face if you use it. And Shade is looking pretty hot here, but this is a pretty sweet match going on. Both players are respecting each other, keeping each other's distance. Shade is using his advantage of the Frieza. Gets the grab, takes off about 5-8% health from Stroke. Stroke and Shade is pretty much just going at each other, but they are respecting each other. And a blue hurricane out of nowhere, even though that looks like a tornado. They called it hurricane for some weird reason. But both players are really respecting each other, and this is a good match, guys. And Stroke is trying to go in, but he still is a little cautious over Shade's power on what he used last match. But Shade using some keys attacks, I don't know why. It was an accident. But Stroke getting some good damage there, but Shade, anytime they're in one at a time with each other, it seems like Shade is taking the upper hand, and Shade going in with a victory rush misses. Stroke going in for a Super Saiyan or Super Vegeta. I think it's a Super Vegeta. He seems more Ki Blast built, but Shade with his paralysis goes in, gets the grab, and he keeps using that paralysis trying for it. In fact, I don't know if Stroke has, if that is a Godbreaker or a Change the Future, but Shade looks like he is avoiding almost all of the damage from the Spirit Ball, and he gets just a minor amount of damage, probably like 5% or less, And after image strike into Shoryuken, will he get a follow-up? He is getting a follow-up, capitalizing on Shroke's gray bar stamina, but Shroke now has a full bar of stamina, but it won't matter because he takes home the finish. And now, since both of those players are out, it is up to Cologne Crow to take home making a comeback for the entire team, or he will be eliminated and we will move on to the next match. But Crow showed his dominance with that perfect. Will he get up again? Perfect blocked the God of Destruction's Wrath. That is kind of hard to tell. And he says, no, you will not get that another one. No, retaliation forever, but give me a kiss. Miss with his evasion and slap to the face. You see the lights coming because I see a train wreck. And, oh, we have a glitch. Crow is taking advantage of the glitch, of probably latency glitch. He was able to maneuver out of that ultimate. And again, stopping the God of Destruction's Wrath. But I will not have any of that. I will keep throwing that out. Doesn't look like it's working. Crow still relentless. Not stopping his aggressive maneuvers. Spirit Ball in the face. Will you get teabag? No! You will not teabag Crow when he is on a roll. He is going in with an arm crash. Second fight of the match. Will Crow still keep his team in the loop? Perfect block for normal. And into... arm crash for days. A delayed hit. Probably latency hit. Taking advantage of that. Mach Dash. This time the God of Destruction's Wrath does hit. Another God of Destruction's Wrath, but Crow was on the edge looking for that, blocked it. God of Destruction's Wrath to punish the arm crash. Crow is very arm crash friendly, and he is going in, capitalizing on major easy damage from 100 melee. And now my character does have 100 in health, so he does have 100 melee damage. He does a ton of damage to be taking off that much health. And Crow still going in. He does not care about the evasion Mach Dash. He says, no, I don't care. I'm going in. And another God of Destruction Wrath takes him down a lot of health. Going for a bait, but does not work. We're down to the match. Perfect block into a throw. Will he recover on time? No! Shining Slash does the matchup into death. On to the next team. Now, it is up to Shade to bring it home. It is this game point right here between Team MD and Team Cake. Will Crow take it home by comeback, or will Shade take the lead and continue on this match? We'll find out right here. Perfect block into an easy combo. Shade's stamina is draining. Crow still has a max bar of ki and stamina. And Shade is out of stamina. Back hits for days. We're seeing a Hulk versus Iron Man. What's going on here? Slapping everybody across the screen. Tries for the paralysis and misses. And Crow keeps going in. But the evasion. Shade is resting on no bars. Goes for a Hail Mary. Blue Hurricane, but Crow is aware of that move from the Blue Hurricane opening frames. In for arm crash victory. Last game, last match, game point. Looks like Shade switches builds up a bit. His preset has changed with his armor, but Crow is capitalizing on his damage. Oh, and the arm crash finisher combo. He says no again. Arm victory rush, and he is well aware. He's very used to seeing a lot of victory rushes, we can tell. And Crow is about to take the matchup, and Shade taunted him, but the taunt wore off, and in for a Shining Slash victory. MD takes it, and K comes. Oh, wait! We have a highlight reel for anybody who was too TLDR. This is for you guys. We see the max reflexes into the Change the Future! Oh, the kill! It's your face! And you better kiss up because I want a kiss. Give me that kiss! Yeah! KO, and oh my gosh, 100 melee attribute. Look what you can do with the Super Saiyan. And he's going to come home for a... Call it perfect! Woo! And we have right here, oh, arm crash, miss, nope. Oh, arm crash, hit, oh! And here we go, we can see the combo power of Crow just taking it home. Obviously way too strong with his easy combos, in for a defeat. Crow going about to take him and slap him, silly! Can he hear the train wreck? Oh, and that troll face. Oh, and my teammate goes down and will Shade capitalize on the freeze? He says, yes, I'm going to corral you and grab you. And, do you smell that tail? That tail has been places you don't want to even ask, buddy, because I'm just going to slap you in your face. Oh, and you like some Spirit Ball, guys? Shade doesn't like Spirit Ball. And here it goes. We're going to see the full power of After Image Strike. Gets hit maybe once, but After Image Strike again. Oh, and he says, sure you can. I don't care about your fireball, Ryu. And he is going in. Oh, but the delay and latency gives him a little bit of damage. And here we go. And for the finisher. So Shade had that one. And here we see the power of Arm Crash over and over. I say, give me a kiss. Crow says, I'm not gay. And I'm going to say, I'm going to just finish this and stay right here. And Crow says, hey, guess what? Knock, knock to your face. You want to do that? No! No, I will not let you turn blue. I'm red. And I'm going to say, I'm about to teabag you. Teabag you with all my balls of glory. Can you see a red train? No! You see the train headlights? I'm going in! I'm crashed for days! Goodbye! And oh my gosh, look at that. He can parry. Oh! Normal parry up close. Again. Oh! Parry the God of Destruction's Wrath. And again. Oh! So much parrying, in for the throw. He says, go over to that corner. Recovery frames aren't going to be enough for you. I'm going to wind up my Shining Slash and take the win. Oh, all over the place. Watch me fly backwards with my wings. And check out the stamina, guys. Perfect block. There goes two stamina bars. Another two stamina bars. Crow goes in. And he's going in for an easy Shiny Slash combo. And Shade must be paranoid at this point because he wastes another two bars. Crow still has full stamina bars all the way up. Goes in for a back combo in his backside. Kidney punch, donkey punch. Down you go. Goes to Crow. And Shade cannot stop this train because he keeps going on and on and on, and there ain't stopping it. No way. Crow is on the edge. MVP. Let's go, Crow. And MD team takes it. So guys, if you like this and you want some more, stay tuned. If you like the highlight reel at the end, I tricked ya. Didn't think that was gonna happen, did ya? But like, comment, subscribe, and I'm going to put everything in the description. Anybody who does have a YouTube channel, I'll put their names in the description as well. Go check them out. And until next time, guys, there is a fight next week. And stay tuned for that one. And I will see you then. Bye!